Today's thought is, one small positive thought in the morning can change your whole day. Good morning everyone, welcome back. I hope all of you are safe and fit at home, studying well and completing your work on time. This video is for the students of class 8, subject English. And today in this video, we are going to cover one chapter of supplementary reader, that is, It So Happened. This is our chapter number 5 and the name of the chapter is Princess September. This is my lecture number 2 of the same chapter. This chapter is taken from It So Happened book. Students, first of all today in this video, we are going to read objectives, key points and summary of part 2 along with word meanings. After then we shall discuss the homework solution of the homework which was assigned you in lecture number 1 of chapter 5, that is Princess September's. So let's see what are the objectives of this chapter. Number 1 is to make the students more nature friendly, freedom friendly, that is taking responsibilities of their own, and music friendly, that is natural friendly. Number 2 is to make the students to familiar with the stories outside the country. Number 3, to inculcate the habit of reading among the students. Number 4, to illustrate the importance and meaning of freedom and its value in the life. Number 5 is to encourage the students to think critically. Number 6, to understand the importance of freedom and how it is linked to the development of the talents. Number 7, to know the importance of music, value of freedom, beauty of nature that forms and shapes the character of a good human being. So these all are the objectives of the chapter. So now let's discuss the main key points of story of part 2. Number 1 is Princess September loves the bird far too much to take chances and acts upon her sister's advice. Number 2, the birds cannot overcome the loss of freedom. Number 3, Princess September decides to put the birds' happiness above her own. So these are the key points. What will happen next? To know about it, so let's read the story of part 2 along with detailed summary and word meanings. It seemed to Princess September that her little bird had been away a long time. Something might have happened to him. What with hawks and with snares? Hawks means it is a type of a large bird that catches and eats small animals or birds. Snares means traps for catching birds or animals. You never knew what trouble he might get into. Besides, he might forget her, or he might take a fancy, means attract towards or attracted towards to somebody else. That would be dreadful. She wished he were safely back again. Suddenly, September heard a tweet tweet just behind her ear, and she saw the little bird sitting on her shoulder. He had come in so quietly and alighted means came down so softly that she had not heard him. I wondered what on earth had become of you, said the princess. I thought you had wondered that, said the little bird. The fact is, I very nearly didn't come back tonight at all. My father-in-law was giving a party and they all wanted me to stay. But I thought you had be anxious, means worried. Under the circumstances, this was a very unfortunate remark for the little bird to make. means worried September. Princess September started worrying about her little bird. It may have been caught in snares. Snares means trap for catching birds and animals. Or it might have been caught in snares. Or the hawks. Hawks means a type of a large bird that cats and eats small animals and birds. Caught it. Or it would or must have forgotten her. But she suddenly saw it sitting on her shoulder. The little bird told September that its father-in-law was giving a party. All wanted it to stay, so it stayed there. No need to worry about anything else. September felt her heart go thump. Thump means to hit somebody, or we can say beat, or we can say to make a loud sound by hitting somebody or something against her chest, and she made up her mind to make no more risks. She put up her hand and took hold of the bird. The bird suspected means doubted nothing, and he was so surprised when she carried means picked him over to the cage, popped him in and shut the door on him that for a moment. He could think of nothing to say, but in a moment or two he hopped up to the ivory perch. Ivory perch means, ivory means it is a kind of an elephant teeth, and said, "What is the joke?" Means the bird in the cage. But Princess September took no chances. So she put the bird into the cage. The bird couldn't believe it. It asked what that joke was. The bird was surprised why Princess September, she was doing all this thing. "There is no joke, but some of Mama's cats are prowling about tonight." Prowling means moving about quietly. "And I think you are much safer in there." So Princess September said to the little bird, said, "Some queen cats are searching for you, so it is better to stay inside the cage instead of outside. You will be safer here." "Well, just for this once I don't mind," said the little bird, "so long as you let me out in the morning." Then little bird said, "If you are keeping me inside this cage only for once, then I don't mind. Then in the morning I will be free." He ate a very good supper and then began to sing, but in the middle of his song he stopped. "I don't know what is the matter with me," he said, "but I don't feel like singing tonight." Then the bird, when after eating his meal, the bird started singing, but in between he stopped and said, "I don't know why I'm not feeling comfortable in this cage, so I couldn't able to sing nicely." "Very well," said September, "go to sleep instead. Now it is better to sing, you should go and sleep." So he put his head under his wings and in a minute was fast asleep. Means the princess told the bird that it was not a joke. Cats were prowling, means roaming in the night. The bird means the bird would be safe in the cage. The bird sang, but it stopped in between. Or we can say that the bird was shocked at the sudden reaction of Princess September. The reason she gave was that the queen's cat might harm her. The bird agreed to it, but for once only. He wanted to sing after supper, but couldn't continue as he didn't feel like or did not feel better in the cage. September went to sleep too. But when the dawn broke, she was awakened by the little bird calling her at the top of his voice. "Wake up, wake up," he said. "Open the door of this cage and let me out. I want to have a good fly while the dew is still on the ground. You are much better off where you are," said September. "Let me out, let me out," said the little bird. And he tried to slip through the bars, means cage of the bar. But of course couldn't, and he beat against the door, but of course he couldn't open it. Then the eight princes came in and looked at him. They told September she saw very wise to take their advice. They said he would soon get used to the cage and in a few days would quite forget he had ever been free. Means the next morning he wanted to be free. His desperation grew. He beat against the door and shout, but all his effort went in vain. Rather, eight princes were delighted to see him in pain. On the request to set him free, September replied that she knew what is better for him or what is better of him. Means the troubled bird. The next morning, the bird asked the princess to let it out of the cage. But the princess told it that it was much better where it was. The bird tried to slip through the bars of the cage, but it couldn't come out. Other princes came. They told Princess September that the bird would soon get used to the cage. But the bird asked to open the cage. Means all the eight princes were happy to see the bird in pain. They didn't want the bird to come out. So they were praising September that you are great, that you have listened our advice, or you have taken our advice. Soon, very soon, this bird will be familiar with this cage, so don't worry about it. The little bird said nothing at all while they were there. Means when the Princess September's sisters were there in the room, the little bird kept quiet. But as soon as they were gone, he began to cry, "Let me out, let me out." "Don't be such an old silly," means don't become fool, said September. "I have put you in the cage because I am so fond of you, because I care for you, I love for you. That's why I have put you in the cage, for your safety. I know what is good for you, much better than you do yourself." Means I know better than you what is good for you. "Sing me a little song, I will give you a piece of sugar." But the little bird stood in the corner of his cage looking out at the blue sky and never sang a note, or you can say stanza. "What is the good of sulking?" Sulking means refuse to speak or don't want to speak, or what is the use of agree, said Princess September. "Why don't you sing and forget your troubles?" "How can I sing?" answered the bird. "I want to see the trees and the lake and the green rice growing in the fields." "I will take you out every day," she said. "It is not the same thing," said the little bird. "The rice fields and the lake and the willow trees look quite different when you see them through the bars of a cage." Means on the request to set him free, September replied that she knew what is better of him. She wanted him to sing for her and offered him a piece of sugar. He could not sing inside the cage. He wanted to see the trees, the lake and willow trees all by himself. He was not willing to see through the cage. He gave up eating and singing. Then anxious princess turned to her sisters for their opinion. Or we can say the bird doesn't sing. The princess asked the bird to sing, but the bird said that it could not sing. It wanted to see the trees, the lake, and the green rice growing field. It cannot see anything from the bar of the cage. It wanted to go and see, wanted to enjoy his life. So please let him out, or please let me out from this cage, said the bird to little princess. The bird wouldn't sing a song and he wouldn't eat a thing. The princess was a little anxious, means worried at this, and asked her sisters what they thought about it. You must be firm, they said. Firm means you should strong or quite hard with the bird. But if he won't eat, he will die, she answered. That would be very ungrateful of him, means that will be not good for him, they said. He must know that you are only thinking of his own good, means the bird should know that you are thinking good for him. If he obstinate, means refusing to change your opinion, or you can say not ready, and dies, it will serve him right and you will be well rid of him. Rid of him means to make yourself free from sorrow, or to make yourself free from someone. Means the bird didn't sing. It also did not eat the food. The other princess told September to be firm, means strong and quite hard with the bird. Then the princess said that if the bird will not ready to do this, then it will die and it will serve him right, and it will be right for him, and you will be free from him also. September didn't see how that was going to do very much good, but they were 8 to 1 and all older than she, so she said nothing. Perhaps he will have got used to his cage by tomorrow, she said. And the next morning or next day, when she awoke, she cried out good morning in a cheerful voice. She got no answer. She jumped out of bed and ran to the cage. She gave a startled cry, for there the little bird lay at the bottom on his side with his eyes closed, and he looked as if he were dead. Means the next morning when Princess September wished the little bird but got no answer, she was shocked to see that the bird was unmoved in the cage. So she took him out of the cage and started crying, or we can say the free bird. The next day Princess September went to the cage. She cried to see the bird as it looked dead. She opened the door and putting her hand in lifted him out. She gave a sob of relief, means she relaxed herself, for she felt that his little heart was beating still. Wake up, wake up, little bird, she said. She began to cry and her tears fell on the little bird. He opened his eyes and saw that the bars of cage were no longer around him. I cannot sing unless I am free, and I cannot sing, I die, he said. The princess gave a great sob, means to speak whilst crying, means but it was not dead. The princess started weeping. The bird said that I couldn't sing unless it was free, and if it could not sing, it would die. Or we can say she took him out of the cage and started crying. When her tears fell on him, he looked up and saw that now the bird is not inside the cage. He couldn't sing inside the cage, and if he could not sing, he would die. So please let me free, because I can sing only openly. I cannot sing in the cage. She threw open the window and gently placed the little bird on the shell, means self. He shook himself a little. Come and go as you will, little bird, she said, means you can go, but return back. Princess September said to the little bird, I will never put you in the cage anymore. I will come because I love you, little princess, said the bird, and I will sing you the loveliest song I know. I shall go far away, but I shall always come back and I shall never forget you. He gave himself another shake. Good gracious means it is very good that you will return back or you will come back and sing for me or sang for me. How stiff I am, how cruel I am, he explained. Then he opened his wings and flew right away into the blue. Blue means sky. Means the bird's word. The princess set the bird free. She promised it that she would not put it in a cage again. The bird replied that it loved the princess. It would come to her. It would sing the loveliest songs for her. It would also never forget her. The bird flew away into the sky. But the little princess burst into tears, for it is very difficult to put the happiness of someone you love before you own, and with her little bird far out of sight. She felt all of a sudden very lonely. When her sisters knew what had happened, they mocked her, means continuously laughed at her, and said that the little bird would never return. But he did at last, and he sat on September's shoulder and ate out of her hand and sang her the beautiful songs he had learned while he was flying up and down the fair places of the world. Means she freed him then and there. He promised her that he would return to her. She sobbed and was feeling lonely. Her sisters mocked at her, but he returned to her and sang beautiful songs for her. Or we can say the victory of love. Princess was sad. She burst into tears. The other princes came to know of it. They made fun of Princess September, saying the bird would never return. But the bird returned. It sat on September's shoulder. It ate out of her hand. It sang her the beautiful songs. September kept her window open day and night so that the little bird might come into her room whenever he felt inclined, means wanted to or likely to do something. And this was very good for her, so she grew extremely beautiful. Means she kept her windows open to let him go or come whenever he felt like. She grew beautifully due to that. Or we can say the lucky September. The princess kept her window open day and night. The bird could come and go anytime it liked. The princess grew very beautiful due to that. And when she was old enough, she married the king of Cambodia and was carried on a white elephant all the way to the city in which the king lived. Means she grew beautiful and got married to the king of Cambodia and was carried on a white elephant. Or we can say that the king married her to the king of Cambodia or Cambodia. She was carried all the way to the city on a white elephant. But her sisters never slept with their windows open, so they grew extremely ugly as well as disagreeable. Means but her sisters never slept with their windows open, So they grew very ugly and disagreeable, means unpleasant. And when the time came to marry them off, they were given away to the king's counselors with a pint of tea and a Siamese cat. Means her sister were married to the counselors only as they were not as beautiful and cunning too. Or we can say the king married them to his counselors. They were given a pint of tea and a Siamese cat each. Siamese means it is a traditional old-fashioned cat. So this was the story of part 2. Students, you have to complete your homework on the basis of the chapter explained by me. And your homework is read chapter 5, that is Princess September, and write word meanings highlighted in the video. Based on the understanding of the chapter, write the answers of the questions mentioned in the book It So Happened As. Page number 43, comprehension check, question number 1 to 6. You have to complete your work in your FAIR notebook by following the correct format. Since many students are not having book with them, so here in this video, I have mentioned your homework in detail. So let's see comprehension check, which is on page number 43. Question number 1 is, in the following sentence, elaborate the parts given in bold. Under the circumstances, it was a very unfortunate remark for the bird to make. Question number 2 is, part 1, what did Princess September do to ensure the safety of her pet? Question number 2, part 2 is, how did the bird react to it? Question number 3, why did the bird refuse to be taken out in her cage? Question number 4, part 1 is, what persuaded Princess September to give the bird his freedom again? Question number 4, part 2 is, how did the bird react to it? Question number 5th, Princess September kept her window open day and night. Part 1 is, how did it help the bird? Part 2, how did it help the princess herself? Question number 6th is, the 8 sisters kept their windows shut. How did it affect them? Students, now in this video, we shall discuss the homework solution of the homework which was assigned you in lecture number 1 of chapter 5, that is Princess September. It is taken from It So Happened book. We have already discussed about the author, objectives, key points and detailed summary along with word meanings in lecture number 1 of chapter 5. As I assigned you homework which was to be done by you on the basis of your understanding, and your homework was read chapter 5, that is Princess September, and write word meanings highlighted in the video. Based on the understanding of the chapter, write the answers of the questions mentioned in the book It So Happened As. Page number 38, comprehension check, question number 1 to 10. So now let us discuss the word meanings of the chapter of part 1. Number 1 is manifold, means of many different ways or types. Number 2 is peculiar, means strange. Number 3 is maids of honor, means women attending the princess. Number 4th is supper, means the last meal of the day or dinner. Number 5th is willow tree, means a tree with long branches. Number 6th is saucer, means plate. Number 7th is vexed, means worried. Number 8th is glum, that is sad. Number 9th is pop, means put or push. So these are the word meanings. So now let's discuss the question answers of chapter 5, part 1. So let's discuss the question answers in detail. Comprehension check, which is on page number 38. Question number 1 is, how many daughters did the royal couple have? The answer of the question is, the royal couple had 9 daughters. Question number 2 is, why were they named after the months of the year? The answer of the question is, they were named after the months of the year because the queen couldn't recall their names easily. Question number 3 is, the king had a peculiar habit. What was it? Why is it called peculiar? The answer of the question is, the peculiar habit of the king was to give gifts on his birthday rather than receive them. Usually people get gifts on their birthdays. Question number 4, part 1 is, what was Princess September's reaction to the loss of her parrot? Answer of the question is, Princess September took the loss of her parrot to heart. She wept continuously. She was put to sleep without supper, means food. Question number 4, part 2 is, what was her mother's reactions to it? The answer of the question is, her mother said that Princess September's weeping was simply nonsense. She asked the maids to put the child to sleep without supper. Question number 4, part 3 is, what do the reactions indicate about the nature and temperament of each? The answer of the question is, the princess was very simple, hearted and sensitive. She was stricken with grief when her parrot died. But the queen mother was not moved at all. She had nothing to console the child. She wanted to make her child bold. Question number 5 is, what pulled the princess out of her gloom? The answer of the question is, the coming of a songbird, or a little songbird, into her room comforted Princess September. She was so enchanted, means affected, that she forgot about her loss or sorrow. Question number 6 is, how did the maids of honor come to know that the princess and the bird had become intimate friends? The answer of the question is, the maids of honor brought in the princess breakfast. The songbird ate rice out of the prince's hand and took bath in her saucer, then sang sweetly. The maids were surprised to find September so much happy. They were convinced that the two had become good friends. Question number 7 is, the new bird was full of new songs, but the old parrots always repeated themselves. What did they say? The answer of the question is, the old parrots only repeated what they had been taught. They could only say, God save the king and Pretty Polly. Question number 8 is, what is the king's opinion about his counselors? Why did he form that opinion? The answer of the question is, the king had a low opinion about his counselors because, like parrots, they too repeated the same thing differently. Question number 9, part 1 is, the 8 princes made an offer to Princess September. What was it? The answer of the question is, the 8 princes were jealous of Princess September's singing bird. Hence, they made an offer to buy her a lovely green and yellow parrot by contributing from their pocket money together. Question number 9, part 2 is, why, in your view, did they do it? The answer of the question is, they did that because they felt jealous of the songbird's friendship with Princess September. Question number 10 is, what did the sisters advise the princess to do about her bird? The answer of the question is, the sisters advised the princess to put the little bird into the cage, lest it should fly away forever. So this is the end of the lecture. Students, if you like our videos, please hit on the like button and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you and have a nice day.